I am periodically getting questions about so-called dual boot, so that is exactly what this whole video is gonna be about. First, welcome. I'm Teresa from Morgonaut.cloud and I help people to save money on their Hackintosh builds and I help them to simply build the perfect Hackintosh. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my videos. So, let's talk about the dual, triple or even more boot option with your Hackintosh build. I don't want to shock you straight in the beginning, but my opinion is simple. I don't recommend to dual boot, especially not for beginners. But if you have still adventure soul, then let's dive into the problem deeper. The reason I don't recommend it is a simple fact that Windows likes to touch and destroy any other system bootloaders during their stupid and very often updates, even disks that don't belong to them. Imagine, you have a Windows build and you successfully installed also macOS on your machine. One day you decide to boot into Windows to play some games. Great idea, okay, enjoy your game, but then you get a message, Windows are updating, don't shut down the computer, blah blah blah, you know it already very well. Okay, so you wait before shutting down your PC, and after your PC is off, you will try to boot your Hackintosh into macOS and bang! Error message, or in the better case, your computer will boot just the Windows and no other system. That's the problem I'm talking about. So, is there any way how to avoid such problems? Yes, if you will follow these three simple rules. First one is the one you don't want to hear. Don't dual boot. It is not just a problem with Windows. It also affects the BIOS settings. Don't forget that for smooth Hackintosh, you need to specifically set your motherboard BIOS. Your Windows will probably need different settings. Always install operating system on separate disks. That means one disk for Windows, one for macOS, one for Linux, and so on. Don't mess with partitioning disks just to save money. A lot of people separate disks into different partitions for different systems, but they forget about bootloader partition is mostly only one for all systems, so each system is touching it in some way. Unless you are familiar with group or other bootloaders, don't do that. Never boot into Windows while other system disks are also connected. So before you decide to boot into Windows, physically unplug other system disks or just disable them in BIOS. These are the only principles that saves you of Windows destructive behavior. I know it's not so pleasant and comfortable to disconnect or disable each time in BIOS the disk, but give yourself a question. Do you really want to go through that process of installing macOS again when your Windows will ruin it and tweaking everything again and again? I guess no. macOS will never harm your Windows, but Windows can harm your macOS. So, let's assume you have already Windows installed and macOS too, and you just ignore all my advices and you want as easy dual boot as it can be. Make sure your Windows are installed in UEFI mode. You can verify it in your motherboard BIOS. When you see a boot option with Windows in front of the name of the disk, then you are okay and your Windows installation is UEFI. Also, make sure your BIOS is set to boot UEFI only to avoid any confusion. With both disks, Windows and macOS disk connected, you must set as a primary boot device the disk with Hackintosh macOS installation. The clever bootloader will handle the boot options for both systems. Now you just boot your Hackintosh. The clever boot screen will offer you all available UEFI installations it can find in your Hackintosh. So in my case here, it found the main macOS installation, then the macOS recovery partition, and the last one is my Windows 10 installation. Now it's only up to you which operating system you will boot. Just use your keyboard arrows keys to select the system you want to boot and hit enter. So let's try the Windows first. Great, booted fine. So let's reboot and boot the macOS. Again, working as expected. So, when we are in macOS, I will show you some options related to the dual boot. Here in the GUI section, you can tweak the settings, what will be displayed on the clever boot screen. These settings you see now should work for 99% of people. Change it only in case you will have any problems. So, as you could see, dual boot is very easy to achieve if you follow mainly the BIOS portion of settings I recommend. But all in all, I personally recommend to use Hackintosh just for macOS and to have a separate ordinary PC just for gaming, for example. This will bring you freedom, good feeling and calm sleep, believe me. I use my fastest and greatest Hackintosh strictly only for all my production work. I need stability, performance and reliability. I need to know that anytime I push the power button, it will simply work. Every day, anytime, all the time. I don't need to worry about I have to wait until Windows will finish their updates or the worst case scenario, Windows will break my Hackintosh bootloader completely. So, think of it like Hackintosh is some kind of workstation, working always as expected. So, I believe you have now already enough information about Hackintosh DualBoot with Windows, so you can set it up on your own. If you liked my tutorial, please click on the like button below. Watch also my other tutorials. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it, so you won't miss any of my future videos. You can also join my Hackintosh and macOS groups on Facebook, Reddit or my website. Links are now in this video description. And if you need any further and deeper help, you can always reach my personal individual support on my Patreon. Thank you for watching and see you next time!